Yeah?
We're on the air.
Oh, are we? Well, this is fantastic. Hi, you guys. Ginger Cook here. We're going to be doing a wonderful acrylic floral today. Surprise, surprise. I knew you'd all be so excited. And somebody who might be watching this live show as we first air it has the opportunity to enter to win this painting, and we'll mail it to you regardless. Did we say we were? I think there is a problem with if you live somewhere we international globe where planes aren't flying anymore, then you'll get something else. But you're going to win something. And we also have the other things we'll talk about in just a second.
Ginger Cook, the queen of color. With a blazing brush at the speed of light. And a blank canvas. And a hearty yes and yes. The queen of color, Ginger Cook, and her sidekick, John Little, teach you to paint with acrylics. Hey, Ginger, I see you're playing with your Salvador paint set.
Yeah, I'm getting them all out here to, everybody says what colors to use. I just like put out the set and then see what hits me, right?
What happens?
I just put out a little bit of all the colors and they sort of, I like all the reds and I like all the oranges and, you know, and I like all the blues.
And there's 24 colors in that set.
Yeah, so, I mean, if you want to know what, this is, normally if I'm doing a big painting, I use our regular, you know, Holbein, or I'll use the golden paints. But on these little small ones and stuff like this, it's really fun to have all the colors. And I'll tell you what, on a show like this, these stay wet longer for me. The paint stays a little workable. It's a soft body paint, but it's not runny like a pore paint.
Not a fluid.
So it's just not a fluid, but it is soft body, and it does have a tendency to just stay wet a little longer, which can be very helpful if you live in like climates like are more challenging for humidity and so forth.
Now the only other one only other professional paint we add to it would be the heavy body titanium white. People, we find their white to be a transparent or a zinc white.
Yes, but very much more transparent.
I sent her a gal a video on that to explain what the difference is, and they may do something about it or just rename it.
Yeah.
They just rename it.
Well, but it's not a true zinc white either.
So it is darn close. When I compared it to the golden.
Yes?
Yeah. They
really
are like neck and neck.
No kidding. Isn't
yep.
that interesting, you guys? So and then I might throw out some Holbein paint here. You know, if we're doing flowers, I always like to have those fancy Holbein paints. And
that would be that luminous rose.
Yeah, this is sort of my go-to pink color. Yeah, that's my go-to pink color because it's really, you can mix it, you have to have at least magenta to get that kind of pink. So when people tell me, sometimes I hear something where someone says, well, I live in an area where I can't get really good paints and colors, and I understand that. And sometimes, you know, there's some colors you can't get. But, you know, do the best you can. Try not to water them down. If you have if you're using less wonderful paint, and by that means less pigmented paint, and you keep adding water to it, then you've sort of made it even worse. Just how's that, right? So that's a thought that I wanted to share today, right, as we're doing that. Now, John, I said that people might win this original painting, and if you're in the United States or Canada, where else can we shipping to? I think we can get to Australia, right?
Australia took 3 weeks. I mean, anything off the continental U.S. is a month or two or three.
Yeah. And you may not.
Some people haven't even gotten them in Sweden and Malta, and it's been two and 3 months now.
Yeah. So because we no longer have the thing called airmail, everything's going by ship, and what they're doing is they're loading up the ships with lots of mail, and then they take it to someplace, and then customs has to go through it, and it's not like they gradually get it drip, drip, drip in and out, out, out. It's all going plunk, and then people are sorting it. So it's even when it gets there,
it's chaos.
It's a little bit chaotic, yes and yes?
Yes and yes.
So this is an interesting color, John, here. I really like this azo yellow medium. This one here is a really beautiful yellow.
It is a pretty yellow.
And that's a nice yellow.
Now, how do you like these paints and compare to the golden as far as the actual quality of the paint?
I actually like the paints very much.
Yeah.
Quality of the paints, I think, are great.
The pigments are marvelous.
The pigments are marvelous. These are great paints. I really like them. And
We just did a show, was it last week, that we did the paint with six colors?
Yeah.
That was a refill kit, and that worked very well.
Yeah, that was fun, too. If you didn't see that, that was good. How to paint, you know, six colors. That particular painting, has it been shipped off yet? Do we have that one to show?
Did you mail that one? Do, as a matter of fact, I think.
Let's show you that. We did that with six colors, and it was pretty good, right? Here's my titanium white from Golden. I'll just put out a little bit of that. Let me thank our moderators for coming and moderating our show again. That's Judy's birthday today. We'll give her a big shout out for happy birthday.
Let me show you this. This is a video I did for her. This is Golden Zinc White.
Uh-huh.
That is their white.
Okay. So it really is it's
identical.
Yeah.
And this is the heavy body.
Yeah.
And this is their zinc. I did the whole thing for
it. Yeah, that's great. It really is. And here's what
we did. It's a great zinc white.
Yeah, here's what we did with the last week with the iris and the three, and just using those colors that were in the refill kit. So if you haven't watched that, well, I'm going to suggest you do.
But don't do it right now.
Well, I've got enough paint out there now. I think I'm pretty happy with that. This is what we're painting today. We're going to be doing this blue vase and sort of a reddish background, a little bit of. Maybe we'll put the glasses in there. I don't know. Might be fun, yes. So that's kind of what I want to paint here today. And I want to make sure that we have... Let me just turn this vertical.
As far as we know, the only place you can get the Salvador paints is online, either directly from them or from Amazon.
Yeah, I never heard of them before. And they contacted us before Christmas and asked what we if we wanted to try something like that. I guess this is going to have to go. It's moving.
I thought it would.
So... I'm going to say about one finger's worth here. I'm just going to...
The old one finger's worth.
Then maybe three fingers above that. And say, here's our... while we're painting this, while we're talking about this, you guys, so many of you answered, you said you really did want to learn how to improve your art. We got about 90-95% of you said that, right?
Yeah, it was 90.
90% of you said you want to improve your art. And so one of the things that we're going to try to, I want to do in this video is just mention some things, even if I've told you before, I would just take a moment, maybe pencil and paper, write them down and have them for referrals, because I'm going to show you some stuff that I think is kind of important. One of the things, when you're doing a vase of flowers, try not to crowd the flowers. Like, for instance, even in this photograph, you see how much room I have from the top. You see there's a space, and you want to have a space. Do you see that? Do you see the space? So I would go down, at least put a dot right there, and you know that you're not going to go up any higher than that with your flowers. And I know that my vase is going to pretty much, I don't want to center it in the middle because we've got a pair of glasses that are going to be here, okay? Fun, right? And there's some reading glasses here, right? Like that. So I'm going to move my vase over a little bit here, and I'm going to draw a line like that, find the middle, kind of make a cone shape like this, kind of same on each side, yeah? And let's put a little handle. And I think I want, for instance, this came up about halfway here, from here to, let me just do something here and I'll tell you what it did. Yeah, about halfway. So that this is about halfway here. So we'll bring this up a little bit higher than that, but about halfway, not quite halfway. We're going to go all the way up. And then I think I'll bring my pitcher down a little bit lower too, just kind of center it in here. And this is a case where you wouldn't want to do a horizontal, or you wouldn't want to lay the picture out this way. You do want to keep it as a vertical. When you're looking at a lot of my tutorials, there's some real thought that goes into whether something should be a vertical or horizontal. Pay attention to that when you're looking at stuff, right? So here's our picture, here's our glasses. And so I have enough information here to know what I want to do for the rest of the floral, right? because I'm going to have my florals come out kind of in an arc. My flowers are going to kind of arch like this. It'll be kind of a two-pronged arch like that, like a fan. That's going to be the shape of the flowers, all right? And I think I'm going to make this vase a little wider now that I see that. Okay, I can do that, make it a little wider. All right, so what's the widest in the middle? About 3 fingers wide in the middle, right in here. All right, so I'm going to put the background in first. This is one of the ruby satin silver angle brushes. You know, you can do all kinds of things with paint, but I'll tell you what, a good brush is your friend. You can make a lot of paint work, but trying to paint with a bad brush can be very frustrating. These ruby satin silver short-handled angle brushes are a must-have. I have everything from 3/8 to half-inch, quarter-inch. I use all the time.
You have all the way up to 5/8.
Have every one they make, right? So, and we have been buying ours from a company called thebrushguys.com, and the reason we do is because they've been giving me and you guys, if you use my name, Ginger Cook, all one word, no spaces, 5% off of already low prices. And yep, they get this stock in a couple times a month, and they sell out fast because everybody knows these are the brushes to have. So if you don't have these, I'm going to highly suggest it. All right, I'm going to take some brown paint.
Oh, just heard from John from over in Ireland.
Yes.
I am told in the UK and Ireland, sorting staff are working with smaller numbers in the post office, also working shifts with no coordination between the posts. So it means the posts could be lying around for weeks.
Oh, my gosh.
So,
I'm going to do a little bit of magenta over this red. Do you see this, what I'm doing here? I'm going to take just this magenta color that they've got, and I'm putting it over red, which gives it a totally different feel, doesn't it? We're going to do something. I always like to do backgrounds a little different than you normally expect. Okay? So let's just come up and down like that. So I'm going, this is just, you know, a red background. And I've got this magenta color. And we're going to just keep going over this. There's no water on the brush. It's just the paint. Okay. I'm not trying to dilute it or anything. There you go. You can see the difference between here and here. Now, what happens when we went over the red is that the red glows a little bit from the inside. You guys see that? So, I mean, I think that's very interesting. See the effect that this has. Well, they're calling this permanent violet, and this is what their color is, not really magenta. It's actually their permanent violet. But I'm thinking somebody, if it was a different brand of paint, it would be magenta. But anyway, this is their permanent violet.
It really looks more purpley than it does.
It's kind of a purple color. It's sort of a purple-red color.
Hey, Priyanka, we'd like to know, are we going to have more European village paintings in July? I haven't painted in a while, but very excited about adding to my collection European store tutorials.
Yeah, and you know what else we've done? I spent about 10-12 hours on a video for our Wave and Water Masterclass that is a phenomenon. And also
first
one of our design series. And that's scheduled for next month, release of next month.
If we get our act together.
Because it's lots of editing. Now you see, that's a really nice glow to that, right?
It is nice.
That's really pretty, and it has this beautiful glow to it. And it allows a little bit of the light kind of shines through, and that's tricky to get. You couldn't mix this glowy color. This is where layers come in. So write that down. It says, ask this yourself the question now. Do I layer enough?
Ooh.
Do I layer enough? Okay. So now the table is going to be a little bit different. I want some cad red medium and yellow, and I want this sort of orange color. Like that. And I'm going to come across here like this. And I'll take a little bit of this purple and cad red medium. A little bit of purple and cad red. That's sort of the red color. Here we go. There you go. That's it. Purple and cad red. That's the color I want. And do you see how that makes almost a mahogany looking tabletop over the red. And then I'll add some more brown to that in purple and cad red medium, just the brown color that's in that. And I'll come under here and just say there's the table's edge. So see, I put that in. The other thing too is that notice that I'm not doing little tiny brush strokes. I'm going all the way across, and such a habit I don't even think about it, going all the way across. Oh, that's interesting, right? And maybe I'll just do a little line like this, same little dark business here. Let's go all the way across like this. There we go. All right, so I've got that part. Any questions, John?
Not at this time, my queen of mine.
All right, so now let's do the vase a little bit. Let's take their ultramarine blue, okay, and just go over the red like this. My brush is damp now, so I've been rinsing it off, and here's my ultramarine blue color, and I'm going to just go ahead and paint this first layer of color. The vase is, remember, kind of curve the bottom of it slightly. Okay. All right. Now that's probably my darkest layer. Let's put a little bit of purple and blue together and just make that a little bit darker in the middle. There we go. Let's just darken that vase up. We're going to build up over that like that. A little bit of purple in that ultramarine blue. Now we've got a nice dark blue vase. And I guess we could put the handle in too. Like that. Okay, we can add that. Maybe we'll just do a little bit of a spout on it. Okay? So far, so good? Yes and yes?
Looking good so far.
Okay, so then what do you do here? Well, this is wet, this is wet, this is wet, this is wet. So the first thing you got to do is dry it. Yes and yes?
Really? Already?
Yeah, so we got to dry it.
Just like that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I'll mute you. All right, while she's muted, let's give you a puzzle update. I finally got the tally of what I've got. I'm still missing 28 people, or have moved out of the village, apparently. So I'm going to be hopefully going to the next group of people that are in line and then shooting out an email that says, do you want to participate? You have 2 days to respond from the date that I send it. And if you do respond, I will send you the piece if you're in that group. The pieces that have been coming in have been doing pretty good. It's going to be an interesting one to put together, to say the very least.
Are you telling, am I back on?
I'm afraid you are.
Are you telling about the puzzle?
I did.
Okay. What did they say?
They don't care what I say, honey. You're the one with the voice.
All right.
You're the important one.
So we don't know what they said?
No.
All right, so now this is dry. Now here's just a little light orange color.
Lena would like to know, does the rule of space at the top apply to all paintings?
No, but it's sure for flowers. And probably portraits, too. You want to give people a little space over their head.
You don't want to cut off the top of their head.
You know? Does not apply, but it sure does. And I'll tell you, one of my best students sent me an original piece last week.
First
and
thing
the flowers
I said.
Were, everything was so perfect, and it was really one of my best students. And the
top was gone.
The top was gone. She just not left any room for the top of the flowers. But the painting was beautiful. She kind of lost that little effect there. Let's put a little bit of white with that now.
The first thing that drove me nuts when I saw it, being a sock folder, I looked at that, and I just shook my head. I go, where's the rest of the painting?
Yeah. So let's just do a little.
What are we painting tonight? Cheryl, we're painting a picture.
Just follow along, Cheryl. It'll be fun.
Do you plan on painting with us right now?
Yeah.
Did you look at the thumbnail? That gave you a clue.
You know. All right. So let's take a little bit of white now and say a turquoise blue color. That's kind of nice. And add a little bit of that, what was that? That little maroon color to this light blue color. Ooh, that's pretty. Let's just come on up here like this. Come over the vase like so. Ooh, neat, huh?
Glad to say it would be an iPad something they did.
There we go. And let's do a little bit of reflected light.
Oh, this that's is, nice.
this is one of those photographs that has more than one light source, which can be very confusing.
Well, what it has is a strong light from one side and a reflective light. They just had a white card on the other side.
Yeah.
Just reflect the light back into it.
So you got to get that a little...
It's pretty well done. So the guy does good work.
So,
or gal, the
gonna,
individual.
We're going to just kind of put a little purple on that now. And just kind of soften that. So you got the dark... You got the dark, pretty much the dark streak in this vase on the, on this little picture on the, on the, in the, kind of in the off center. Here you go. There you go. So there you go. So you see, I'm starting to, this has to, this curve here, and this curve here have to match. Got to be the same curve, okay? So, let's just put the, let's say here's the, where our handle is attached. And in the photo, there's a kind of a nice little scarf that's here that's pretty. There's just this little bit of fabric scarf, and I was debating whether to put that in. I didn't want to make things too crazy for you. We'll hold that thought, and if we need it, we'll put it in. How's that? The original, and of course, when you're a beginner acrylic academy basic supporter or academy student, either beginner or senior academies, you have access to the actual original photographs that we use, not just my painting. You have that. And by the way, if you're finding that YouTube has gotten a little crazy on the ads recently, we don't have any control over that. If you want to watch any of our videos ad-free from this year on YouTube, come to our website and become at least a basic supporter, and you can watch them with no ads. No kidding. So for those, you know, some people, you know, otherwise you could just, you know, skip an ad, that kind of stuff. So I think that's kind of neat, right? Don't you think?
I think it's great.
Is that a little bit of light right there? See, that's kind of neat, right? Yes and yes. Then let's just do a little bit more right here, like that. Play with the lights.
Hey, we'd like to thank WS for the donation that came in through the Super Chat with the screaming guy going, goal!
Wow.
I love those little guys. Somebody's very clever.
Love it. Love it, love it, love it. I think there was a little bit of something in here. Just some sort of light was reflecting on this table. Not sure why it was, but we'll put it there anyway for now. Okay, so I'm happy with my background. I think it's really kind of fun. So, what do we got for flowers? Let's take a little. Here's what you want to do. Figure out. Remember, I said that you know you're going to go down through three, so you're not going to go up any higher than that. But I do have one here. I'm going to put a little X where I've got one, right? And I'm going to just do my a few little X's where I know I want some flowers. Just even if it's a dot, and I want my biggest flowers. I want one. Right here, and I want a pretty big one here. I want one there, and I'm going to have one that's going to have a leaf that's coming down like that. Here's this one, okay? Another little flower right here. We've got one coming this way. We've got some beautiful flowers in this vase, and we want to make sure that I have them all in here. Okay, here's another one coming out this way. And, okay. So I know whatever I do, I'm not going to get them up too far past this one. All right, so that normally they're about three, and this one's a little closer, but not that much closer. So that's where my flowers are going to go. So let's take that light green color. One of my favorite colors in this set is this light green color. I absolutely love this one. It's called... yellowish green, and it's a neat color. I want to just go ahead and add a few little flower stems. Now you can, this is that little pointed brush that came with the set, and you can use this, or you can use your angle brush, or you could use a dagger brush. Now, having brushes is the bomb, you guys. Here's a dagger brush, and let me show you the kind of line you get with the dagger. And they should be damp. And a little bit of darker green with that. Okay, and I'm just going to put in a few, using the dagger brush here, I'm going to put in a few leaves like this up here. Let's gray this green a little bit, adding some red to it on this side.
Connie would like to know, I think it was Connie, wait a minute. No, Cheryl would like to know, what do you think of the brushes that come with the set?
Well, you know, they're really kind of watercolor brushes for me.
They're soft.
They're very soft. If you were painting on paper in a watercolor effect, they'd be lovely. They're lovely brushes. They're just, for me, they don't work as well for acrylics. I'm telling you what, I don't fool around with brushes.
which is good to know.
Yeah, I'm telling you. You know, because, you know, what would people say, but... I'm just saying that I don't want to fool around. Your brushes, boy, if you've got a good brush, it's everything.
We feel the brush is more important than the paint.
Yeah, for me, you know.
And the way Ginger paints, she needs a stiffer brush. She likes to push her paint, not just lay it down. She moves it. She moves the paint.
There it goes. Just a little something light right here, like that.
That's
on this one.
That's a good way to put it, boys. What do you think?
You think I'm moving the paint, John?
Mm-hmm.
All right. So you can see where I've got a few little greeneries up here, like that. All right. So the thing about green.
Do you plan on painting the train for the June photo?
I don't know if I do or not. Maybe I haven't decided. I've been very busy trying to catch up with the design class, so maybe not. We'll see. All right. Here's the, I see. Now I understand. Okay, so we're going to start with a kind of a dark blue-green color, that green with a little ultramarine blue, yeah? I'm going to come up here like this, and I want to put a core into this little bud that's coming out here in the greens, all right, with me? I'm going to start with this color.
These, again, for those that are just showing up, we're using the Salvador paint set. It's a professional grade paint. It's not a student body paint. It's a soft body, not a student grade paint. It's a soft body paint, though.
Yes.
We find the pigment to be very strong and vibrant.
Exactly so. Okay, I think that's these. All right, that's those. You see how I've just been still playing with the greens, right? Now... they've got a magenta color here and white. Let's just play with theirs first because it's a nice, here it is. There's their magenta. And I want a little light blue with that color. And I want to make it a little bit more
purpley.
Uh-huh. And that's, I did too, look at that. That's nice. So I want to come out here with this, let's see, let's put some more white with it. And then I want a darker color, so let's try a little bit of that.
The discount coupon is good for both things now. Anything that Salvador comes out with, they say you can use our discount code on, which you can find in the description of the video, and also a link to these paints.
Okay, so you got my first flowers up there.
I'm liking that one. That's got some cool color in it.
Yeah, doesn't it? Isn't that pretty? That really does, doesn't it? And then it's got a couple little smaller ones up here that are just sort of half ones. Just coming up there like that. And this little brush here, this dagger brush, is pretty effective with that, right? And then it's got... now, this was interesting. The picture has found some flowers the same color, but different kinds of flowers. So, let's see. I'm going to start with the blue first. Let's take a different blue and add to that color. Okay, that's pretty. Now, let's come back up in here, and we're going to just put this flower in, almost like a, not sure what these flowers are. You know who's the gardener in our group is Kim, and some of you other people are too. I don't know what this flower is, but see, I'm...
Kim will tell us.
But here it is, and putting it... See how it's still wet? I'm going straight into the white paint.
All it says is field... They're wild flowers from a field.
Yeah, and see how I'm going over the this flower with the lighter paint like that. See? Put that in, right? And I'm trying to think of what I can do before it has to dry, okay?
The Salvador, no, I'm sorry, the dagger brush is also a ruby, it's not a ruby satin, what do they call that
it's
one?
It's a silver, it's made by the silver company.
It's a silver brush it's company, the same people.
It's the same people, but it's a Bristolon.
Bristolon, that's it.
Yeah, Bristolon, same people,
it's still
Bristolon.
Same silver brush people that do the ruby satin silver angle
okay,
brushes.
Okay, so then here's this little peach flower coming out like this. That's pretty, isn't it? That's this.
That's
color
a nice
was
color.
That? That's this.
Is that color you like?
No, it's just that. Well,
it's another one you like.
It's a little bit deceiving because you can't really tell what they are. I think it's this one right here. It's called. That's not the Azo Yellow. Where's that one? This was like a. Here,
so
what's
just,
this? It's this one. It's the red Naples red yellow. Is that it? Yeah, this one's called Naples yellow red.
So it's really not as orange as the tube looks.
No, no. So, I mean, I'd almost want to put a thing on it like that so I could see the color, so I know what it is, you know? Because that's sort of fun, right?
Yeah.
Well, that's kind of a nice little bright flower. And as long as we're playing with bright flowers here, let's take that and put a little yellow with it and change that up a little bit. I want to come this way. I'm trying to put flowers in so I don't have to dry. How's that, you guys? So I hope everybody had a nice weekend.
Oh, did we have a weekend?
We did. We did.
You know, when you're inside all the time, how do you ever know?
We don't know. We were just saying that just the other day, that it's a real... This has been... These have been challenging times, have they not, friends? Coming out from the center of this green one like this, so some of that dark green shows in here, like that. And the same thing here, you want this green, that coming out from the center of this so that you have like a green core to these. But I have to say, it has been a bit of a challenging weekend for just in general. Trying to, you know... You turn on the news and they have something less than fun, and so I've just quit watching it. I just, because living in Houston, we're all hanging in there quiet.
Well, yeah, we're a hot spot.
We're all just being kind of quiet. So, all right, now we're going to come out with a little white, and just on the outside of this one, there you go, the next edge on this, like this is like three colors, see? So this has got those three colors in it, which is kind of, these look like, I could call them wildflowers, you could call them weeds. I think it's, these little things look familiar. I have kind of a vague memory of these little white puffy things. So I like that pale yellow color too. This is a nice color. It's not quite white, this one right here. It's not real yellow, but it's a nice color right here, like that. There you go. It's kind of cool. A little bit of that up in here like this. Now, what could I do? Here's the thing. I'm not putting in every flower that was jammed into this photograph, all right? We're doing what I like to call the Reader's Digest edit of this, yes? Yes and yes?
Well, sure.
So we want to do that first. We're going to do that. So the next, I'm sort of layering these in as I go. Like this little flower here had the next little thing it had is, let's see, something very bright. Okay.
Could those puffy flowers be called milkweeds?
Yeah, I think they're kind of a weed. They look like a weed to me, man. You know? A little bit of white up on this one.
Could be a milkweed. milkweed pods. Seems to be
some
consensus.
Sort of like a little pod. Don't they look like a little pod to you? Right?
Yeah.
And, okay, so there's that little flower. Now I want to put in these pretty little pink flowers, and they look like almost like small hyacinths to me, which is interesting because hyacinths are generally, they're a spring flower, they're a bulb, they smell so nice, right? But they're that shape. I don't know what they are, but that's all right. We're going for that, right? And let's see. Let's take the magenta color and white. There you go. That's the color I want, that magenta kind of color. And a little bit of the darker purple with it. And I'm going to just tap these in, okay? I'm going to start with my darkest colors first. And I'm going to just tap in flower right here. Just using the tip of this brush. Because you're not going to see a lot of this and they overlap. And this one's kind of behind there like that.
What was that color you used on the background over the red? That was that magenta. They called it a violet?
Yeah, that was that maroon color. But it does have this great glow. Look, can you see it? See how it
sort of
glows?
Because I'm doing the side angle, and you can really see it. It really looks nice on it.
It's pretty, isn't it? It really glows nicely. Yes and yes.
I'll consider that a semi-transparent or translucent paint.
Yeah.
That particular color.
Yeah, for sure. I think so, too. And I want to come over here in the front of this. This is one that's kind of looking at us. And we're just going to make a little circle here because it's looking at us. Okay, right like that. Now, in goes the white. Still wet, yeah? So we're just tapping right on top of these. On the light's kind of coming this way. So we're coming and tap on the right-hand side of this. And I'm kind of smooshing it into the paint.
Smushing, yes. That's a technical term. We don't like to use those very often.
I know. I'm smushing this in because it's still wet. So as I touch, I might tap it two or three times. Let's see. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. Get more paint. Because
are you
it's
trying
mixing,
to show everybody
it's
you can
mixing,
count?
It's mixing. No, what happens is that people do one and then stop and then wonder why it didn't work. It's almost got a woodpecker kind of tap to it. You know, because I'm making this light pink color, and I get new white every time I do it. See? So now these flowers are showing up. The same thing with this one. See? It's on the light hand, right, you know, on the left-hand side is where we're doing it. Now, I still could put some Holbein. I could take this. If I want these brighter, and I'll show you the difference.
Oh, here we go.
Take that.
Bringing out the big guns.
I just, and it probably would be better to dry this first before I add this color. But now, look at the difference. Just a touch. You can overdo stuff, but let's just make this one in the front really much brighter.
Dab, dab, dab.
Dab, dab, dab. It really is. It's sort of a dab, dab, dab business. Tap, tap, tap it in, right? Like that. So you've got these pretty pink flowers, and I've got a couple more of these. I think I'm going to put another one right here. Kind of a little pod-like one here. And just go into the white. It's a sort of just sort of a little light thing there, right there. So because these flowers are layered, let's see, we're going to put another one back here. Do you guys, here's something to write down. Do you remember to rinse your brush once in a while and wipe it off? Because remember your paint's drying in your brush, too?
That's bad.
And then you have to really wipe it off so you don't drip water like I just did on the...
That's even worser.
Yeah. Okay, and put a little of that light blue with that color, like here. And I'm going to come up here and do a kind of a little purple flower up on this area. See how? Ooh, that's a great purple, isn't it? That was that. That's this light blue color and the Holbein Luminous Rose. And what a great color that is. Look at that. Too much white paint. Okay, so there's that one. And let's do another little dark blue one up over here. Just some little tiny one.
Brenda says Ginger is looking fantastic.
Oh, thank you.
Let's have a look at you. Well, let's see, it's the top of your head. You know, that's all anybody ever sees is the top of your head. Well, the top of your head is looking great, my dear.
Thank you.
What is she dabbing? Color? Yeah, she dabs color.
Just a little bit of color.
Lots of color.
Going to get that little blue or that one flower. How about this one, too? I like that color. The luminous rose with this light blue color is gorgeous. With that light blue color, like over here. Look how much, look at how that's popping this one up. Make that a little darker. Too much paint.
All right, so really coming along like a beautiful painting.
I mean, this is kind of cool. I mean, you could just, you just have to kind of go a little bit slower than you think, and just take your time, dry it, or just chat like we're doing here. Let's get some pink out of this one. There you go, on that one up there. Then that one's sort of sparkly. All right, so we got some nice flowers. As long as we're in this color, let me come down to my pot, and I'm going to wipe the color off my brush and then drag it down on here. See that? Just on the front of this pot right there, that luminous color. And a little bit of white with it. That can be nice. See, just sometimes you can do just a little something, and maybe a little bit of white in that light blue color. Let's put some white with that.
Patricia would like to say, how many cookies do you think this is?
Oh, I don't know. This is not hard, you guys.
No, it's a pretty simple one.
This is pretty simple. You know what it is? Most of a lot of new artists use too much paint. They put these big, they don't have brush control because they're putting too much paint on the brush. They're not putting paint on the brush and wiping it all off. You see how I'm constantly knocking off the excess paint? And you want to be able to do that, right? Just keep going with this. I'm not sure I'm going to...
Since you've been using the dagger brush a lot lately, I don't have a dagger brush. What angle brush would I be using?
Any of the angle brushes would work on this.
Because you're going to be just using the tip of it.
Yeah. Any of the angles would be great.
I'd do probably a quarter or 3/8 because you're on a smaller painting.
Yeah. So I've got this. Now, I want a couple other these other flowers in here, and I'm not ready to put those in. So I'm going to let this dry for a second. I want to show you guys some stuff.
Right? Oh, you want to back out a little bit,
I bet. Back out a bit. I want to show you some stuff because people always sit there and say, we know we do a lot of flowers on this channel, but people like to watch them. And, for instance, here's another blue vase one. That's a blue vase. That's it's one of our old dead artists that we were inspired by. And you can see that, again, different way to paint flowers, right, than, say, how we're doing it now. Here's a, this was one of my favorites. This was a Russian lilacs.
I like that one too.
And what I loved about this, and I called it that because it was originally a Russian artist that came up with this. And I love the blue vase, the same kind of thing. Look, it's very similar. Look, if you painted that one, couldn't you paint this one to match? I mean, wouldn't these make a nice pair, even though they're slightly different in color? But what I loved was the light around this blue vase here. I love that, right? And that's a YouTube lesson. People always think we only talk about that. Here's another one with the lilacs. I think, was this an Academy lesson, John?
Yes. One?
This was an Academy lesson?
I do believe.
And I think so. I have to ask Judy, remembers. This is an Academy lesson. Was it, Judy?
We have people that remember things for us.
Because Judy puts them up on Pinterest, right? I want to point these out because there's a lot of, if you like this kind of thing, you know, you'll notice that these little lilacs are all just delicately painted. And then we had that wonderful lilac window in our Quarantine Quickies. That's in the Beginner Acrylic Academy. Here's another one that was on YouTube with the. I love this with these big pink flowers and this turquoise vase. And then I believe this was an academy lesson we had with the lemons and the blue vase. So blue seems to be a good color for vases, doesn't it?
It seems to be.
I just pulled some blue ones, right? Because I thought you guys might like to see it, right? And why not, right? Ooh, where'd that picture go? Oh, we hooked it up there. Ooh, it got caught on something. Okay. All right, so that's probably, has that dried? No. Let me dry that, John. Perhaps you can share some interesting stuff with our folks.
Okay. I don't know what interesting stuff I can share with you, but I'll come up with something, I'm sure. How does question go by? Let us see, Ginger paint some rabbits. I'm not going to say no on that one, but we got to find the right rabbit to do. If we can find Harvey again, he would be the rabbit of choice. The actual photo on this particular painting she's doing right now, the light source is coming from the left, basically square at it on the left, 90 degree angle, with a reflective card, I'm guessing, on the right. It's pretty soft lighting, though, overall.
So you good with this? Are we back?
Yeah.
Okay.
I even turned you back on, too.
All right.
At least I think I did.
I think this, this actually had a spout, I just didn't see it. Isn't that funny? Come on. This is Magoo's painting here. Here's the spout on this.
Oh, like when we were doing the...
I swear there's a lot of that going on. Just never saw that. Right, there's a little bit of a spout right there. Oh, yes, you're going... So of course, that should have been there. Yes. Yes and yes. Okay, there's our spout. I had to put that, right?
Got it.
So, because I'm layering this, I'm going back with the... with those cute, these puffy things. And, because they have this, whatever these guys are, we need the center sort of a dark green, kind of blue color. So I'm going to put another little dark center back here, like that. That little area right in here, like that. It's going to say that's that flower, okay? And then, in order for that to work, that has to dry. So let's just ignore that for a minute. And I think we'll put in the glasses. I like the reading glasses, right? But we probably should do the table a little better. Let's make another orange color. Here's some orange. Here we go. Just kind of glaze over that light part on the table there with a little bit of orange. Maybe a little water. That's where you want something light. You want something translucent. Just put a little water with it. And look what that does over that light color. You see it's still light. You kind of wipe it off a little bit, but you've stained it like a dirty shirt, right? There you go. See how we've got some light on there, but I've stained it, which kind of looks good. And I wanted just something more. And in fact, I think I'd like more of that light color. So how could I do that? Well, let's just play with this for a minute, right? Let's put some light streaks in this table like that, because I do like that. Let's see, they have a tablecloth behind it, so you don't really see it. And let's just move this along like this, this edge. And then we'll come back and we'll glaze over it. Because that's always looking good, yes? So, I mean, those are just some things you can do. Is this still wet? Yeah. All right, so what else could we do? Oh, yeah, we could not have water on our picture. All right, so I think what I'm going to do, because I'm not going to do the tablecloth, you know, the sort of scarf that was here, I'm not going to put that on there. I think what I want to do is maybe suggest that there's some, that there's a high shine to my table. You know how when you polish like wood and it kind of reflects? Let's play with a little bit reflection then. What do you think instead? So let's come in here like this. Now, this is not a shadow. This is what I would call a reflection from our lamp. And this is where their white would be handy. So let's get their white out, because I want a little translucent white, right? And
Gail would like to know, how do you put the canvas in a frame?
Oh, I've got the most beautiful video on how to frame these. You just can't, it's how to frame it, you know, how to frame it and mount it. And it's on YouTube. It's one of my best videos I've ever made. You're going, really? Well, some people think so. How's that? Let's make that a little bit darker right there. See how we just, we created that effect of the, of a little bit of a you know, just a little tiny bit of a reflection. Yes and yes.
That lets you know it's a shiny table.
Yeah, it lets you know it's a shiny table.
That white really did a good job with that, really.
Yeah, didn't it?
That's what that white is.
Yeah, you're right, John, it is. Okay, so there it is. There's our reflection on the table. Now, this is probably dry enough where I can take a little bit of just some that orange color and water. Make sure there's no purple on it. Because this has to be dry, but now look. See how it tints that back? This is called glazing, and you can glaze with water. Usually I use glazing medium, but if you're doing something small like this, you can glaze with water, and you see that gives that table just enough of a little bit of some highlights, and you know, then if you need to, you can come back and add a couple more, but play with that too. Play with glazing. Ask yourself the question, am I glazing enough? Yeah, that's what you want to ask yourself. And the same thing here next to this, here's a little bit of this purple color in water. Now, if we come back up here on our table, our wall rather, right in here, right? So I can add a little bit, just with water now, I can add a little bit of this and create a little bit of a shadow on this wall right here. And what did that do for our pot? But it made it stand out more, didn't it? And just so, you know, that's, think about that. Am I glazing enough? You know?
Hill would like to know, Ginger, have you ever painted wine, grapes, and cheese on platters?
On what?
On a platter.
Well, I just generally paint on canvas.
That's a good one.
That's just sort of my thing, right? But, you know.
I think she's asking, as a still life. You wine, know, wine, grapes, a little
where's
crackers.
Where's our picture, John?
What?
Where's our picture that we just did
with it's my wine and grapes? It's hanging in the hall.
Would you like to grab it and we'll show that?
Would I like to grab it?
Yeah. Now look, I'm doing the same little, here's my angle brush, you guys, while he's getting that. And I'm using the same little angle brush like I was with the dagger. I don't want you to think you can use your little angles too. You could use a Posca pen. If you're having trouble with small stuff, use a Posca pen. Okay, so while he's getting that, I'm gonna take my light color here and we're gonna go ahead and do this flower right here. Front. This is the one. This is dried enough now. Where we're going to say that there's our. Okay. There's our other little picture. To see how we just how we snuck that in. And. There. Now, the one I was going to show you, could you back up a bit? Where's my square frame, too? Should I get it? Should I leave? Should I get it?
Oh, John, my queen, I would not expect
no,
you.
No, John wouldn't expect me to move. Certainly not. Not.
No, my
not,
queen.
No. Not.
What size frame would you like?
Yeah. Hey, did you guys know it's the Art Sherpa's birthday on Wednesday? It's my daughter. It's her birthday.
Happy birthday to the Sherpa. Did you want the square?
Yeah. Was this the square? Yeah. Yep, here we go. Move back. All right, so there's
but now
the,
you're assuming I'm backed out far enough with the frame and everything.
Yeah, John's going to back out. This is our grapes and wine glass that was released
last week.
Last week for our our Academy of Fine Arts Acrylic Painting Senior Academy. And we have a special supplementary video on how to get a perfect glass every time. how to deal with the, this is a really cool, because this is a wonderful video on how to overcome a photograph that has two light sources and screwing up with your image, and some things that, and how to change a painting after it's completely dry and you think you're done. So this is a, that's a must watch, and I think that's quite cool. But yes, to answer your question, we have, and then of course we just did a, for YouTube, remember we did that long skinny one, the wine and the bottle and the grapes and the vineyards and all that stuff. We got a lot of that kind of stuff on in our academy. So I'll put that down here like that. All right, this is kind of, we're doing pretty good here with this, yeah?
So far, so good.
So, I think, you saw where we put that one in. I think I want to do the glasses. So I thought the glasses were sort of cute. So, I'm going to use a Posca pen for my glasses.
Ooh, really? Going for it.
Because I need something very skinny. And here's the thing. Here's what we're going to do. I want you to think of a box like this. Draw a box like this at this angle, okay? Yes? Yeah?
I got it so far.
So far, so good, yeah? There's a, then this is going to, the glass hinges are going to come, this one comes up a little higher, I guess, then. Well, they come out pretty high. Is that, well, I don't know why they come up so high, but I guess they can, right? So then in here, there has to be two ovals. Does that make sense? So I'm going to say that there's my, widest one.
Looks like you put some Mr. Magoo glasses on it.
Almost round, not quite, okay? This one's a little rounder than that one, okay? And, yeah, this one's really, this one on the left is very elliptical. This one's a little rounder, okay? And then on the inside of these guys, it's sort of a peach color. This was, they were kind of peach-colored glasses, not rose-colored, right? So on the inside here, it's my, see how I can get a skinny little line that way? You see, I was able to just, easier to paint the line than to, you know, draw that out, right? And then, let's take a little bit of this white color and put a little bit of a highlight right here on these lenses, like that. And then they had, this is their kind of transparent white. We're going to say there's, from these, that they're kind of doing that, right? So now what? Well, I think we could do a little bit more of that peach color on this side. Okay, with me so far? Now, I have to dry this, and then we're going to get out the black pen, and I'll show you how to finish these. Sometimes there's certain things you can do with the brush, but remember, the pens are still acrylic paint. It's like you're not cheating if you use a microwave when you're cooking.
Oh, man, I was worried for a second.
I know. People think, oh, no, you know.
And you're cheating.
You know, ovens are okay, too. We used to just do campfires. We progress. Enjoy, here it is.
Enjoy progress.
Enjoy the progress of the progression you've got. You've got projectors. You've got transfer paper. You've got videos on how to paint stuff. You've got endless images to find on the internet to paint. Even if you never got off and found your own photographs, there's places like you can paint, find things to paint. So take advantage of it, right?
Before you do that. Mm-hmm. How much was art school in your youthful years? Did you go to art school?
Well, I went to college, university, Arizona State University. I took art classes, so I don't know. My parents paid for it. I had no idea how much it was.
Didn't matter.
But it was expensive, right?
And well, then, at the time, but I mean, they do it by quarter hours or whatever.
Yeah, and when I took private art lessons from other artists, right?
That's expensive.
That was expensive. You know, I'd find some really good artists and take private lessons from them. And so, you know, it's always about learning things.
Always. Okay. Please proceed. All righty. And anything else? Is this a glass tabletop? No, but it's a polished tabletop. From what I can tell from the photograph, it is not glass covered, but it's highly polished. Good varnish on it. Good shiny wood. Anything else going on in here we need to talk about? We did allude to the fact that we just finished up our, are finishing up our first design class for our Wave and Water folk, who are going to be our testers. And we hope to have that up later, well, in July. See now it's July. Oh, speaking of July, we will be having our first official auction of the year in July, about the middle of July, as we finish up and get ready for that.
Yeah. All right, so you know about your Posca pens.
I do know about my Posca
pens. And you want to make sure you've shaken them up very well. This is the fine point ones have, they have a clear, well, this one broke off, but it's usually a clear plastic thing here. They're fine. We're using the very fine ones. This one was not a fine one,
that
but this one. This one was, all right? And generally speaking, there we go. So, and then you push it. Now, if you get a puddle, that's okay. Just test it first, right? Now, if you thought of these eyeglasses as a clock, I'm going to start at midnight, 12 o'clock, right? And I'm going to come around here till about 6 o'clock and stop, okay? And the same thing on this one. I'm going to come around here until about 6 o'clock and stop. You don't really see the black on the other side, which is kind of important, yeah? And then here's the... let me just blow this up so I know exactly what I'm looking at.
Yeah, make sure you're going the right, because these look like they're laying down.
These are laying down. So here's the nose piece in here like this. That's connecting them, right? And then this one is, oh, they crossed them over. But this one goes kind of back like this. And then it goes up. And this one is coming from about, not quite 3 o'clock on this side, and it's crossing over like that. All right, so they kind of, he crossed them over like this. So he had, and here's the way the nose piece fits, okay? So then I've got my, I'm going to do a white one a little bit. So they're almost there. I mean, you can really see them, can't you?
Yeah, it's looking good.
I want to just on this side, just kind of reiterate my white. And then right here on the back of these, I didn't dry this, so I'm really, really pushing it. There, okay, so there's our glasses back there, and then here's the... There on the nose piece, yes and yes. And then here, a little bit of white right next to that black line. Like that. And are those lovely or what, huh?
The glasses make it.
They may. I mean, that's just, I mean, you got to admit that's fun, isn't it? I mean, just really, and you just had to think about how to make them for a minute, yeah? And now what the other thing that's there that you may not have known is that there's a little tiny shadow right here where there's like a little glazing shadow right here under these glasses. So right here there's a little shadow coming back this way. Put a little bit of purple with that, I think. There you go. So see, that sort of kind of sets them in there, doesn't it? When you put the little, I think that's where the shadow went, right here, like this, under here, like that. Okay? Let me erase it where it doesn't go. So it came from about 6 o'clock, and I had it about 2, and I'm going to erase that right there. There. So there's our little, there's our dark shadow right here, right under here. Back like that, right? And then you've got your Oh, this is so fun, isn't it? You've got your white coming like that on the this, and then let's do a little bit of light. As long as we're doing it, right? Fun. Let's do a little more light right here. Let's just play with the lights on this. You can do so much. Let's just play with another bit of light right here on this now. On that vase and the... And let's see, we want a little bit, we want to exaggerate this light right here. Yeah, okay. So I think we're pretty close to being finished. I just have to do some light greens.
So you have not entered and would like an opportunity to possibly win this and or, no, it wouldn't be and or a chance to win the... A Salvador paint kit.
Yeah, you want to
do that.
You want to enter now and let's
enter pick. Now because right now we've only got 314 people that
really
that's are all? Interested. That's it.
I'm surprised.
I am too.
Because you can win a Salvador paint kit. We're gonna put a little of that green over in front of that one. Okay. And. Put a little light green on this one too. Let's just pull the just brighten up some green here, right? A few little stems. I'd say we have a nice bouquet of flowers. We could have, you know, could you put more in there? If you looked at the photo, you might have been tempted to put them all in. But then you got to ask yourself the question, and this is key on any painting, what can I take away and not ruin the effect? Not what can I add, but what could I get rid of? It's just, did you ever read the Reader's Digest stories when you were a kid? I used to get, I subscribed to those books for years, and I'd get all the novels and, you know, and I loved reading them because I got the story without 15 minutes of describing what the sofa looked like, you know, and how nice the wooden door was. And so it got me into the story. I was used to being a very impatient reader in those days.
Oh, so, and you're not nowadays, are you, my queen?
Well, maybe I might be. So that, you guys, is, I think I'm going to pull a little bit of this.
All right, we're going to be drawing for it. The Queen has completed another fine episode.
Another fine episode of YouTube. Yeah, and how cool is this? To get rid of this yellow, as I thought would be great on it, but yellow really doesn't do it for me. Here, let's just put this against gray, so it's sort of neutral gray. Let me just show you. This is a really cool painting, I think. You just have to... See, the yellow got a little bright for me. Yellow paper, put that away. And, you know, I think this is really fun. And it says something without saying anything.
It says something without saying anything.
Yeah, you know what I mean? A lot of times, you know, people like practically write books on what they're doing. You know what I mean? And they put everything in it and, you know, but this is a very... This sends a message without saying anything. Does that make sense to you?
It does. Absolutely.
Yeah?
No doubt in my mind.
A little bit of light up there on the top. Playing with the light and what it does. You know, you can play a long time. But I will just stop and sign it. You ready to draw some fabulous winners?
I have drawn the drawing.
Have you?
I have.
Okay. Cool. I want to mention two things before you tell people.
Here's please.
This is summertime, and I know a lot of us are...
enjoying the inside.
Enjoying the inside, and the beach is kind of out, but if you feel like a beach party, this is an oldie but a goodie. This was in our academy. One of my favorite paintings is this... this woody beach wagon. In fact, we even have a T-shirt in Teespring that says "Got a Woody for Art."
Very appropriate. This picture.
So I love this, and it's a palette knife painting. I love it. If that's in the Academy, sometimes we have so many pictures in the Academy, over 400, you get a little overwhelmed. And if you felt like you didn't get to go scuba diving this year, here, this was in our Wave and Water Masterclass a couple years ago. This is when we released our dolphins and the underwater scene. People have asked about that. We have all kinds of stuff in the Academy. Like I say, over 400 lessons. Check us out. And they come with personal art coaching. So I'll shut up now. You can tell people who they want.
No, don't you? Did you do the Wave and Water for them?
Oh, no, I didn't do the Wave and Water. And we had to catch up on Wave and Water. We know we did. We had the golf one last week. And this is going to be Wave and Water for July. Here's our. This is from one of our older artists from the 1800s. And again, a different way to paint water. When I think this is really kind of cool. That's our Wave and Water for July.
I think that's a pretty one.
I'm going to sign this now.
All right, I will announce the winner of the painting.
I think I'm going to sign it in black so it doesn't take away from my glasses.
Winner of the Kim Rantlett. Kim Rantlett is the winner, and she's all the way from Michigan.
Hey, Kim, congratulations. That's awesome. So she won the original Ginger Cook painting?
Original Ginger Cook painting.
Good for you, Kim. That's awesome. Who got any other winners?
We do. We have another winner for the Salvador paint kit.
While John's saying that, I just want you guys to see how close we got to the, I want you to see our wildflowers like that, see? I think we did pretty good, just by the way. Okay, sorry. Go ahead.
Oh, that's all right. I'm just visiting.
Go ahead.
Just passing through.
I know.
Okay, winner of the Salvador paint set. Boy, you can't spell tonight. Is Elizabeth Ayer. A-E-R?
Ayers?
A-A-Y-E-R? Ayer?
Ayers? Ayers? Ayers, probably.
Elizabeth is the winner of the Salvador paint kit. Both people, I need your mailing addresses, please. And thank you.
Well, you guys, this is way cool.
What's cool now? What are you going to do?
The fact that I'm not doing anything. I just think this is way cool. Oh. You guys won some stuff. We had a good time. It's a Monday, and we did another fabulous acrylic painting. And what's your favorite weed flower?
Oh, I don't even know the names of them.
Me neither. All right.
I like the pretty ones. I
mean, remember, we'll be back Thursday with something else extraordinary.
We're not going to see you until July. So yeah. Get over it.
And remember, Wednesday Cinnamon's birthday, it's on July 1st. And so.
Is she going to be on the air?
I don't know if she's going to be on the air.
Well, she is.
I sent her something really cool. Maybe she'll share it. That sent her something really cool. I'd tell you what it is, but one of you might tell her.
Yes,
can't tell you. No. I'd share
Once the word. All right, everybody.
Bye.
See you later. Ciao.